You ready?
Company number three is the big dog, right?
Yeah.
And I heard the story, but just walk us through. I think it's very interesting. I think it's a takeaway as how the idea came to you, as far as just to start the Pluto TV idea.
Yeah. So I was sitting with my daughter on my lap, right? And I'm picking out YouTube videos for her on one monitor and working on another monitor. Mm-hmm. And I find it that it's like I'm not really good at it whatsoever, right? So I pick out a video. She watches it for 2 minutes and her attention span goes away. And then I pick another video, it's inappropriate. I shouldn't even be playing that video. Yeah. And I really looked at myself and I just learned how to change diapers and I'm by far—
You're in the trenches. You're in the dad trenches.
Yeah, now I have to be the expert of children's video. It made no sense to me, right? And what was interesting about the internet is everything was about search. But what if I didn't know what I was looking for, right? And that's when it all clicked, because I knew when she was in front of regular TV and watching like Disney Junior or Nick or whatever it was, she could watch for hours.
It was rolling.
But online, somebody had to do all this work.
People want to be fucking, like, we think we want everything. Like, we think we want the choice for everything.
Exactly.
But we—
There's a paradox.
We want to be curated too.
But if you actually survey people and you say, like, let's use music as an example, like, right? We've had literally the choice of any song anytime we want since the days of Napster.
Right.
Like literally.
Right.
Right. Napster, Apple Music, Spotify, anytime, any—
Now more than ever, obviously.
So, but 88% of music consumption today is still people curating to you. It's radio, it's FM, XM, and playlists. Mm-hmm. Right. So even though people think they want this choice, when you actually give them this choice, they don't know how to make it. And they freeze up. They don't want to do the work. It
takes time.
But if you ask somebody, like, do you want somebody to choose for you, or do you want to do it yourself? Everyone would say, I want to do it myself. Right. I want the choice. But in reality, that's not how humans behave, right?
Interesting.
So the concept for Pluto was, let's take the best content online, right, and curate it into channels, mm-hmm. right? Because like TV, when you don't know what you want to watch on TV, you literally hit the guide button, you see what's on, and it's limited. It's 8:05 p.m., or whatever time it is, and here's what's on.
Right.
And here's what's on this channel. You have maybe a choice of like 50 things, 60 things. Right. And maybe if you have 5, 6 favorite channels, it's really only 5 or 6 things.
Right.
Right. And you come home, you're tired, you put on HDTV or whatever it is that's on the background, MTV, and you just let it run. And I saw that is how people consume content. And online, it made no sense because there was no experience like that whatsoever. Online was everything about search. And look, search is very, very good. On demand is amazing if you know what you're looking for.
Right.
But it's a horrible experience if you don't know what you're looking for.
Yeah, and it's a rarity to know exactly what you're looking for every time. Right. Like you said, a lot of it, how many, like I saw something like average American watches like 5 hours of TV or content, and, you know, like.
Yeah, over that, yeah.
And it's just like how much of that is actually pointed? I think a lot of it is just impossible. Like,
there's no way you could pick 5 hours. Like an average American, as you said, watches about 5 hours of content, video content a day. There's no way you're choosing. The 80 plus percent of that
go off immediately when you?
So I took a little bit of my money, right? And I hired like a remote engineer and two remote developers actually, and built a prototype.
So so in layman's terms, you create your goal was to have these people curate channels of pointed content, meaning exactly. Like all a theme, like.
So I came up with like channel ideas, like, oh, let's do cat videos, let's do stand-up comedy, let's do news, right? Similar to what TV had, but also some unique stuff that TV didn't have, right? So then, you know, let's say you want to watch stand-up comedy on YouTube, but you don't know which comedian or you don't know which specific video, it's very painful.
Right.
But what if we can get a comedian or somebody who knew comedy to make a stand-up comedy channel? And YouTube already tells you what the best videos are. They have the most views. So let's just put them in order. So I built a prototype where I purposely, so we plugged into the YouTube API and we removed the controls. So people couldn't rewind, they couldn't fast forward, right? And I put videos back to back to back. And I forced a TV-like experience where you literally landed into a guide. And if it was 8:05, at 8:05, if you're halfway through this Bob Saget video, everybody would be halfway through that video. So everybody would watch the same thing at the same time. So very similar to television, it made this like kind of synchronous experience. And people in the beginning were like, if I can watch it from the beginning, why are you forcing it here? Because I didn't have to force it, right? But I essentially made live in a fake way. And it worked.
You ready?